We're still about 6 months away from Mustangs baseball at Philwell Stadium, but with the news of general manager Kai Turner buying the team from the original owner Dan Gerson yesterday, it's time to go down memory lane a little bit and take a look at how the Mustangs started.
Not every town has a baseball team, and you know, the Mustangs, we've done pretty good at what we do.
Seven Mink League championships in 12 seasons, the St. Joseph Mustangs, arguably the best club in the league since 2009 when they came in. And with Tuesday's announcement that general manager Kai Turner has bought the team from Dan Gerson, the man who brought the team to St. Joseph, it's time to look back on how the Mustangs created this buzz in town.
It's not because of me. It's because of so many other people and so many people through the years that have worked.
The creation of the Mustangs started in 2008 during the final days of the St. Joe Blacksnakes, a team that never really grabbed the community spirit. But St. Joseph's baseball history goes back much farther than the Blacksnakes, more than 100 years in fact. And the passion passed down from generation to generation, Hall of Famers playing at Phil Welch Stadium. But with the Blacksnakes' exit, that left some skeptical for the future.
I remember those first couple years, you know, when Rick and Kyle Fetter said they had some business meetings with people and just the struggle that they were faced with because of you know, where the Blacksnakes had left the community.
For years, baseball fans enjoyed the St. Joe Saints at Phil Welch, but once that ended, it took a while to get the spirit back until the Mustangs arrived.
By seeing what the Blacksnakes were doing wrong, it helped me know what needed to be changed.
I think there's a core group of baseball fans in St. Joe that have been, are now, and will be.
Lyndon Black, a St. Joseph Baseball Hall of Famer for his time with the St. Joseph Cardinals many years ago, was one of the key figures who helped bring back the Mink League, and he was the president of the Saints for 3 years, says he saw a lot of potential in this new team.
Dan and his crew have pretty much picked up where the Saints left off, and I think that's why those folks have come back. And support the Mustangs.
But before the Mustangs could get started, a lot of renovations needed to happen around the stadium, which meant Gerson needed to convince the city.
That first council, Mayor Sharon, they saw what this could be. I mean, they were the ones, the city took risk too. The city, I put a good amount of money into the deal originally. The city put a great amount of money renovating the stadium.
And with the city supporting baseball again, the Mustangs were born and baseball was about to thrive in St. Joseph once again.
You know, it's not something that you can just bottle up and take to another community and spread it out and you know, up pops a team like ours. There's a lot of hard work, a lot of great people.
It would never have been successful without that early support from the St. Joe government.